In this video, we are continuing with the series of alternating current class 12th. Now we'll start. Our unit name is alternating current, that is AC. And our first topic is alternating current. So alternating current, as the name suggests, is the current which changes direction after every half second. For example, if I can represent a current like this. So this means, suppose we are having an AC generator, okay? We are having an AC generator and say these are the brushes B1, B2, say. Okay, so in class 10 we have studied ki what is AC generator. The generator in which the current changes direction after every half second is called what? AC generator. So the current will flow from B1 to B2 for 1/2 second, and for another half it will flow from B2 to B1. So current which changes direction every half second is called what? AC, that is alternating current. Now since it is alternating, which means it is changing, so we can represent alternating current by sinusoidal wave, which is I is equal to I naught sine omega t, where omega is the angular frequency, or omega can be written as 2 pi f. Now what is f? F is the frequency of AC, that is alternating current. If it is 50 hertz, pay attention, if it is 50 hertz, so direction will change 50 times in 1 second. Getting my point? If it is 100 hertz, so the direction will change 100 times in 1 second. So this is what AC is. The current which changes direction after every half second is called what? AC. And the representation of AC is what? I is equal to I naught sine omega t, where omega is what? 2 pi f. F is what? Given frequency. Now since sine wave is sinusoidal wave, so this AC can be represented by sinusoidal wave. So this is I and this is say t. This is time period. And this is the peak value. The maximum value of AC is called peak value. It can be represented with positive sign when the current is from B1 to B2, carbon brush, and when it is reversing the direction, it will be from B2 to B1. So I'll write minus I naught. Now pay attention, minus I naught here does not mean the value of current will be negative, because it is a scalar quantity, it is always positive. It only means it has changed direction. That's why it is called alternating. So this is the basic definition of AC, that is alternating current. And don't confuse this with AC current. Sometimes it is said AC current. This is wrong. AC is alternating current. You need not to add current further. Okay. So this is what alternating current is. Representation is I naught sine omega t, where I naught is the peak current, and omega, which is equal to 2 pi f, where f is what? Given frequency, which signifies how many times the current will change direction. In how many seconds? 1 second. Okay. So similarly, since AC can be represented by what? I naught sine omega t. So the voltage that we are getting from AC can be represented by what? The same sine wave. So if I am to represent, our second heading is AC voltage. So it can be represented by V naught sine omega t. Okay. V naught sine omega t. So similarly, we'll get the same graph. Again, it is sinusoidal. So it will be plus V naught and it will be minus V naught. Okay. And the interesting thing about what AC current or voltage is that their average value for one time period for complete cycle is zero. Whatever value we are getting for first half, from 0 to t by 2 is positive, and from t by 2 to t it is negative. So it averages out to be what? 0. So key points are AC is alternating current represented by sinusoidal wave. Again, AC voltage is sinusoidally changing, and the average value of AC and AC voltage is what? 0. In the next video, we'll discuss the proof of why the average value of AC and AC voltage is 0. Thanks for watching.